Guys, it's Chilly here. This is going to be a very short little update video. Those of you who hang out in the Discord probably already know, but I've been back from my honeymoon for about a month now. Things have been super crazy at work, but I've been managing so far to get a regular schedule of videos out. And in fact, we've just finished the math arc of Advanced. So now I'm ready to put all my effort, all my attention into cranking out 3D fundamental videos. In fact, this weekend, we are going to be doing point light sources. So these are the topics tentatively that I think we have left for 3D fundamentals. Six topics, six videos, maybe seven. I'm not sure yet. I expect that these 3D fundamental topics, they're going to go by pretty quickly because unlike advanced, which is two and three parts plus homework, these guys are all just single videos and they're easier for me to make because there's less live coding. So should be pretty quick. And then we can get into hardware 3D. If I play my cards right, there shouldn't be too much of a gap between the end of 3D fundamentals and the start of hardware 3D. Also wanted to share with you guys something I've been working on over the past few days. It's gonna be a web portal where I can post coding challenges and you guys can log in, submit your code, and you'll get ranked. There'll be points for submissions that pass all test cases. You might get 30 points. If you only pass the small test cases, you time out on the big ones, you might get 10 points. And then there'll be bounties, big bonus points for the person who can submit first and pass all test cases, and one for the person who submits the fastest code overall. So I'm going to run coding challenges like I've done in the past, but it's going to be on this website, and I'm going to create some tools that'll help me automate the evaluation process. So it should be a lot easier for me to do this stuff, and that is going to be good because I can do it more regularly, maybe once a week. I'm thinking coding challenges, stuff like you might see on HackerRank, the kind of stuff that pops up in whiteboard interviews when you're interviewing for a programming job. So as before, I'll post a video with the problem, and there'll be a thread in the forum, and you guys code it up, but instead of messaging me on the forum, you're just going to submit by uploading the file on the Patreon dashboard. So I'm going to make it so that even non-Patreons can have an account on the Patreon dashboard. And theirs will be, well, mainly for submitting code challenges and for keeping track of your rank in the leaderboard. And when the code challenge is finished, I'll of course do a solution video, but it should be fun. It's in the last one, I basically just, if you won, you won. If you lost, nothing. But now just being able to finish it will allow you to accumulate some points. It can be fun to keep track of your position in the leaderboard. I think it'll be a good time, and more details on that once I've gotten more of the interface down. Another thing I wanted to do for a while now is do another stream. Thinking of what I might want to do. Maybe I want to just play around in assembly programming for a little bit of real mode assembly programming live on stream. And you guys can come along and watch that if you're interested. Not going to be a tutorial, just me messing around in assembly, but of course it's a live stream, so you guys can ask questions about things and I'll probably answer them. So let me know what you think about that. But yeah, that's pretty much what is going to be going on for the next little while. Thanks for watching, and I will see you soon with some more C++.